The John LeBanks Show has been known to make people laugh, sing, think, scream, throw things in rage, and generally lose their minds. Listener discretion is advised.
Greetings, Earthlings, and alert the media. The John LeBanks Show is now on the air. Federal budget runs a $666 billion deficit in fiscal year 2017. Interesting. Sixth highest on record on top of that, ladies and gentlemen. The last fiscal year for President Barack Hussein Obama was the sixth highest deficit on record, and it just happened to be a big 666. And this federal budget outpaced the growth of tax collections for the second year in a row. According to the Treasury Department on Thursday, the budget shortfall rose to $666 billion, the number of the beast, in the fiscal year that ended on September 30th, up $80 billion or 14% from fiscal year 2016. That tracks with the estimate from the Congressional Budget Office. They got one pretty close this time, which had predicted a $668 billion deficit for the last fiscal year. Now, the federal tax receipts reached a high in fiscal year 2017 at $3.3 trillion. Thanks to slightly faster growth, according to a senior Treasury official. So, the increased stock market gains over the past year probably helped rake in enough tax revenue to help the fiscal budget a little bit, you know, that deficit. But the government outlays also hit record highs last year at nearly $4 trillion. That's how much it costs to run the United States federal government, $4 trillion. They take in $3.3 right there at the top of all time, yet they still spent $666 billion, don't want to have them spend that much money. Too much. And this was due to the increased spending in Social Security, Medicare, and Medicaid, as well as higher interest payments on public debt. So you get that, ladies and gentlemen? And you people who were freaking out that the Republicans would hurt the little guy and cut government programs, they're spending more on government programs like Social Security, Medicaid, and Medicare. So everybody who thought they were going to hurt the little guy, mostly those people who vote Democrat and who just hate people with the R next to their name and who don't realize that both sides apparently are on the same track. You see, nothing got better with the Republicans in office up there in Congress. Nothing got better. They're still spending like crazy.
What difference at this point does it make?
And this has no, you know, oddly enough, and we may hear that this last budget was a Trump thing, but it's not. This was the last year of the Obama administration, 2017 fiscal year. This is everything that was put in place last year when they were getting ready to shut down the government. Do you remember that? They're always getting ready to shut down the government, and some deal is made, and they get to keep running the government and then giving us higher deficits. Sixth highest last year. Hey, we figured it out. That's okay. At least we're not the first highest deficit
So those Republicans who were sent into office to not only reduce the debt, not only to repeal Obamacare, not only to do a whole bunch of other things, are really no different than the Democrats when you look at this. And the people who are on the Democrat side who get all upset about having a Republican in office, if they would look at this objectively, the scenario bears out that the Republicans aren't willing to get rid of things that they were elected to do. So the only people who should be really mad about the Republicans holding power in Congress are the people who elected them, because they're not following through. Even this new tax plan that is being talked about, the particulars of it are starting to shake out. And we're seeing that, well, our 401ks may be affected by these things. They're going to cap it again. Not that I'm a fan of 401ks. A lot of people have them, though. And a government who spends more money than they take in, they're going to find ways to keep money and then make it look like they're helping you out. And we're not going to see a real tax cut. I mean a real one, if there is a tax cut coming. Because we can't trust the Republicans any more than we can trust the Democrats. $666 billion. I mean, it's like an omen of everything, isn't it? The beast is here. It's been here. It didn't go away with the election of Donald Trump. And as we're noticing with the sheer mass opposition to what Donald Trump is attempting to do, and outside of some executive orders, which I can't approve of. I mean, I like the ideas behind the executive orders. I just don't like legislating with the pen, you know? The deep state, the swamp, is not being drained. The swamp is protecting itself. And even if Donald Trump had enough allies, I don't think they're going to be able to drain enough of the swamp by the time he's out of office, if he's for real. But as time goes by and I see the opposition to him, I begin to wonder if he's really their enemy. He might be. I don't know if he's an ally to the American people and the Constitution. In fact, I have seen little evidence of the latter. I don't think he cares a whole lot about the Constitution. I don't even know if he knows much about the Constitution. But the opposition to him, and when you see people like, because it's getting bad. It's getting so bad out there that the establishment has to drag out Barack Obama and now George Bush to go out there and talk against Trump. The great hated George Bush, and I can't wait to hear the people who are going to praise George Bush for standing up against Donald Trump, because a lot of them hated George Bush. But because he's against Trump, apparently, because he's against Trump, it's going to be okay. He's going to be like, they're going to use his words to bolster their opinion, bolster their position. It's amazing to watch the entire establishment throw everything at Donald Trump. And he's been, you know, he's got a ding or two And he causes a ding or two himself. But here we are. I mean, what, 10 months into the administration? And I don't think he's all that damaged. And the people who elected Donald Trump may not be happy with the, you know, how things are shaking out. But they still support Donald Trump a heck of a lot more than they support any of the establishment people. They may not be happy with Mr. Trump and what he has accomplished so far, because it hasn't been a whole lot outside of some executive orders. He personally hasn't done a whole lot. But that's because we got a do-nothing Republican Congress and Senate up there. That when they have the chance to do something that they had promised for their constituents, they fail. And they constantly fail. And they don't get it done. And they don't agree. So we have to, as the average citizen of the United States, the people, while we sit back and watch, we have to wonder, why is the entire establishment trying to stop Donald Trump? Now, it could be all a game to keep us all occupied, because I believe they've understood that the American public no longer falls for the duality of Republican and Democrat, and that there is a alternative mainstream out there. You see, I don't think that everybody believes Republican and Democrat, and I believe a lot of people, because it's the idea, the concept of being an American is being different than the rest. Not being part of the clique. See, they want you to be part of the clique, and that's where they get you. And that's when you know if you have an individualist or a socialist or a communist or a collectivist. If they want to be part of some group, they're not an individual. They're going to act like they're an individual. But when they use the terms like Black Lives Matter and they never came up with it, all they are is a little bit of puppet, little bitty puppet. They're like that guy on the movie Brewster's Million who would repeat everything that Richard Pryor would say. That's all they are. Little marionettes dancing around to the beat of somebody else's drum. And you can tell right away the difference between an individual and a collectivist. And of course, right here on the John LeBanks Show, the people who do listen to this show, the majority of them, if you're not here to pick holes in what I say and attack me for some reason, you're an individual. You think outside the box. You're part of the alternative mainstream. The part of America that does not get any attention. In fact, they demonize people like you and demonize people like myself. They ignore you if they can't demonize you. If you're too clean to be demonized. Man, don't have any skeletons in your closet, because the establishment will find it and use it against you. They'll either manipulate you, or even worse, they'll just slander you. Destroy your character, your person, your person, everything. Sorry, folks, I was looking at the clock because we're up against it again. You hear the music going in the background. Sometimes I get on a roll and then we run against the time and then I have to stop. And that's one of these times. Stay tuned as the John LeBanks Show will return after a word from our sponsors.
I'd like to welcome our new sponsor, Pane in the Glass, commercial and residential window cleaning. For a beautiful, sparkling shine that's crystal clear, call Pane in the Glass Window Cleaning. You can find them on Facebook at Pane in the Glass.